once you study about nomenclature, the next part of it is regarding about the structure of carbonyl group. The next part here is about structure of carbonyl group. Now, when you study about the structure of carbonyl group, we are not discussing more details inside it, but just an highlights of this carbonyl group. We can see here in the carbonyl group, I told you there is carbon which is having a tetravalency, that is there are four valencies around it, four bonds around it, out of which two bonds are satisfied or two valencies are satisfied with oxygen. Now, if you look into the hybrid state of this carbon here, the hybrid state of carbon in the carbonyl group is sp2. Why? Because carbon wants to form three sigma bonds around it, or it wants to get linked with three other groups. Therefore, it will use sp2 hybrid state. And in this sp2 hybrid state, you can observe that the three sigma bonds are already there, whereas the fourth bond is a pi bond. Fourth bond is a pi bond. How is that pi bond formed? The pi bond is formed, as you know, the orbitals overlap sideways, parallel overlap. That means in sp2 hybrid state, there will be one electron, what you call as valence electron, in the p orbital, in the p orbital of carbon. And this valence electron then overlap with the half-filled orbital of oxygen sideways, and that forms a carbon-oxygen pi bond. I'll repeat here, in carbonyl group, the carbon atom is sp2 hybridized. It forms three sigma bonds by utilizing the three sp2 hybrid orbitals containing one valence electron. By overlapping that sp2 hybrid orbital with the corresponding groups, whereas the remaining one valence electron of the p orbital of carbon then overlaps with the valence orbital, half filled valence orbital of oxygen to form a CO double bond. That is how we can discuss about a structure of the carbonyl group. So once you discuss about the structure of carbonyl group, in the next part, we will now discuss about the methods of preparation of aldehydes and ketones. Methods of preparation of aldehydes and ketones. When you go with the preparation of aldehydes and ketones, there are the methods which we use mainly for preparation of aldehydes and ketones together. At the same time, we use some method which is used for the preparation of aldehydes and also some methods which is used for the preparation of ketones. When you go with the methods of preparation of aldehydes and ketones, okay, there are different methods here. In that, the first method of preparation of aldehydes and ketones is from alcohols. Alcohols, as we all know, it is one of the very important family of organic compounds, which is having its own application. At the same time, it is also having plenty of application in other organic compounds also. Now, how to convert an alcohol to aldehyde and a ketone? When you look into alcohols, there are two ways in which an alcohol can be converted to aldehyde or a ketone. Which are these two ways? The first way is by oxidation. Now, what is oxidation? Oxidation is a process of addition of oxygen, one simple way of defining oxidation. Now, who is providing this oxygen? It is provided mainly by some oxidizing agent, or we can use some elemental oxygen. So, when you take an oxidizing agent, we say that oxidizing agents are of different types, like strong oxidizing agent, mild oxidizing agent, etc. So, when you take a strong oxidizing agent, and if you want to convert an alcohol into an aldehyde or a ketone, the problem is you get aldehyde or a ketone, but the product is not pure. As soon as you use a strong oxidizing agent like potassium permanganate or potassium dichromate, the aldehyde or a ketone that is formed will get immediately oxidize to give you a carboxylic acid. That is why a strong oxidizing agent is not preferred in this method. Then how to oxidize? For that we are using some specific oxidizing agent which you might have studied in your chapter of alcohols. So what is that specific oxidizing agent? For example, if I want to prepare an aldehyde, let me start with a primary alcohol which I represent in this way, RCH2OH. A primary alcohol, you know that a primary alcohol is that alcohol in which the OH group is attached to a primary carbon. A primary carbon, okay? So this primary alcohol, when it is subjected to oxidation with one specific oxidizing agent called PCC. What is PCC? Pyridinium chlorochromate, which is nothing but a complex of chromium trioxide, CrO3, in pyridine and HCl. I'll repeat, PCC is a complex of chromium trioxide in pyridine and HCl. That is PCC. And this oxidizing agent, if I use, I have got the tendency of getting an aldehyde in a relatively good yield. I'm not getting a 100% pure aldehyde, but a relatively good yield of aldehyde can be obtained using PCC. So here, a primary alcohol, when subjected to oxidation with PCC, it gives you the product an aldehyde. The equation what I have written here is nothing but a general equation which you can apply to any type of aldehyde, like formaldehyde, where R group is H. I want to take an R where H group is there, it becomes HCH to CH3, which is nothing but methyl alcohol. So methyl alcohol on oxidation gives formaldehyde. Ethyl alcohol on oxidation gives acetaldehyde. Like that, higher and higher alcohol gives higher and higher aldehydes. Suppose if I want to get a ketone, then I should start with a secondary alcohol. That secondary alcohol, I can represent it like this, RCHR-OH. This is nothing but a secondary alcohol in which the OH group is attached to a secondary carbon. And this secondary alcohol, when it is subjected to oxidation with chromic anhydride, CrO3, then we can get here a product that is nothing but a ketone. A ketone is obtained by the oxidation of a secondary alcohol using chromic anhydride. A secondary alcohol, when oxidized using chromic anhydride, gives you the product a ketone. If I start with isopropyl alcohol or 2-propanol, CA3CHOHCA3, I'll get CA3COCA3, acetone. That is how we can go with the explanation for preparation of aldehydes and ketones from alcohols by oxidation. The second method of preparation of aldehydes and ketones from alcohol is by a process called dehydrogenation. Compared to oxidation, dehydrogenation process is considered to be one of the easiest and the best process for the preparation of aldehydes or ketones. The reason is very simple. In dehydrogenation, the product obtained is in a pure form. Pure form. So what is dehydrogenation meaning? You can see that word DE. DE meaning of the word is removal. Hydrogen, removal of hydrogen. So from an alcohol, remove hydrogen, you get the corresponding aldehyde or ketone. How to dehydrogenate? The method is like this. Suppose if I take primary alcohol and if I pass the vapors of primary alcohol over heated copper catalyst or a heavy metal catalyst, heated copper catalyst at about 573 Kelvin, okay, the product what you get here is this hydrogen gas is removed or H2 is removed and you end up here with RCHO plus H2. So here we get the product an aldehyde. You can just observe the byproduct, which is the gas which escapes out. The only product what is left over is an aldehyde. So there is no problem of this aldehyde getting further oxidized because there is no oxidizing agent in that reaction. Therefore, yield is better, purity is good. That is how we can take the dehydrogenation process. Similarly, if I take a secondary alcohol, the secondary alcohol I can represent in this way, RCH R dash OH. So this is a secondary alcohol. Secondary alcohol, and vapors of the secondary alcohol, when you pass it over copper catalyst at around 573 Kelvin, what you get? This H2 is removed, and what you end up here, it is RCO R dash plus H2, which is nothing but a ketone. This is how you can convert an alcohol to an aldehyde, either through oxidation or by dehydrogenation. And all the equation what I've given here is pure a general equation which you can adapt to any type of example whichever you want to study. So that is about the second method of the first method of preparation by two different ways. The next method of preparation here is from hydrocarbons. This is another important method of preparation of aldehydes or ketones. Now, when you refer to the word hydrocarbon, one of the most common term what we find in organic chemistry, hydrocarbons. In these hydrocarbons, varieties are there, and among these varieties, I'll pick two. One is olefins, what we commonly call as alkenes. And second one is alkynes. So how to convert an olefin or an alkene into an aldehyde or a ketone, and how to convert an alkyne into an aldehyde or a ketone? So what is the method here? The first one let me take is by ozonolysis of alkenes. Ozonolysis of alkenes. When you refer to the word ozonolysis, you know this word. Ozone is a triatomic oxygen having a formula O3. This ozone is used in this reaction. Main purpose of studying this reaction is to identify the position of double bond inside a molecule of alkene. So this ozone is having a typical tendency to add across the double bond. And there it forms a product called ozonide. This ozonide formed is then reductively cleaved, means it is broken down. That's why it is lysis, ozonolysis. You are adding ozone, you form an ozonide, and that ozonide is broken down. And to break down that ozonide, we use a compound called zinc. We call that process as reductive ozonolysis, reduction. Where you remove the oxygen from that ozone, and that's why it is reductive ozonolysis. But during that process, you end up here with the product aldehyde or a ketone. Now, the nature of aldehyde or ketone depends upon the nature of alkene what you take. Suppose if I start with the simplest of an alkene, which I represent like this, RCH double bond CH2, where R group can be hydrogen, R group can be even an alkyl group. These alkenes can be of different varieties. I just taken one hydrogen out from this carbon and substituted with R group. I can remove all these hydrogens and substitute with R group. That will change the nature of the product. So in the first step, what I'm doing, I'm just taking an ozone, which I already told you is triatomic oxygen, O3. This ozone will add across this double bond. And when it adds across the double bond, it gives you RCHO CH2OO. What is this? This is called ozonite. So this ozonite that is formed here is now heated in the presence of zinc in aqueous medium, where it will give you the process like this. This bond is cleaved in this way, this is cleaved in this way. So what we end up here, it is RCHO plus CH2O, which I can represent it as HCH. That means, depending upon the nature of R group, you can get an aldehyde. Formaldehyde is one common product there. So you get here a product aldehyde along with formaldehyde. So this oxygen is removed, that is why it is a reductive ozonolysis. This is how we can convert an alkene to an aldehyde. Suppose if I want to get a ketone, then I can prepare a ketone by substituting these hydrogen atoms. Okay, this is an alkene, simple alkene. Okay, if I start with a simple alkene, that is ethene, CH2 double bond CH2, I end up here with only formaldehyde. If I start with propene, CH3 CH double bond CH2, I get acetaldehyde plus formaldehyde. So like this, you can keep on changing the R group and change the product you want. But if I want to get a ketone here, the ketone I can represent it like this, I can represent a alkene like this, RCR double bond C R dash R dash. You can keep all the R and R dash group same. You can keep two R dash group in different way, or you can change all these R groups and R dash group. So depending on that, you can get a different type of ketone. The nature of the reaction is same, where ozone is added across this ketone. And what you get here? You get here R, C, R, O, C, R dash, O, O. This is how you are getting an ozonide. And this ozonide, when it is subjected to reduction using zinc in aqueous medium, what you get? You can see here, this bond breaks like this, this bond breaks like this. So what you end up here? You end up here with two ketones, RCOR, R dash, CO, R dash. This is how you can prepare aldehydes and ketones from alkenes by a method called ozonolysis. This is one of the way of converting an hydrocarbon into an aldehyde or a ketone. The next method that is from hydrocarbon is by a process called by hydration of alkynes. Alkynes is another category of aliphatic hydrocarbon, unsaturated aliphatic hydrocarbon. But here I want to just go with one simple way, that if you start with alkyne, the simplest of the alkyne is acetylene, which I can represent in this way, HC, triple bond CH, triple bond CH. We call it as acetylene, or which is IUPAC name is ethyne. It's acid catalyzed hydration, means you are adding water in the presence of an acid. So if I go with acid catalyzed hydration, I can see here I'm adding water. And this water is added in the presence of mercuric sulfate and H2SO4, acid catalyzed hydration. Now, if you observe this reaction, this you have studied in first year under properties of alkynes, where this is following a simple addition, electrophilic addition route, which is following the Markovnikov rule. And based on that, we get one intermediate product. That intermediate product I can represent in this way, where water is split as H plus OH minus. H plus is adding to one carbon, OH minus is adding to another carbon, and you get here one product. We call it as enol. Enol, a common name for it. Okay, enol. Now, this enol that is obtained here is then subject to a process called isomerization, means here it is undergoing tautomerization, and this tautomerization gives you the product CH3CHO, that is acetaldehyde. So if I start with acetylene, I end up here with acetaldehyde. An alkyne other than acetylene will give you the product a ketone. Other than acetylene, the second member, if you take propyne, you end up with a product ketone. Like that, higher alkynes gives you the product K ketones. So acetylene, when subjected to acid catalyzed hydration, gives you the product an aldehyde, which is acetaldehyde. So that is how we can go with the preparation of aldehydes and ketones, okay, collectively from alcohols and from hydrocarbons. So once you study about the preparation of aldehydes and ketones, now I am explaining to you mainly about the preparation of aldehydes. Now as I told you, it is a stepwise method, preparation of aldehydes and ketones together, then we have got methods of preparation of aldehydes. In the next stage, we will go with the methods of preparation of ketones. So when you speak about methods of preparation of aldehyde, there are some special methods, some very important method which is very much required for answering for your final examination. So which are this method? The first method of preparation of aldehydes is from acid chlorides, This acid chlorides are also called as acyl chlorides, Now, what are acid chlorides? When you refer to the word acid chloride, acid chlorides are actually one of the derivatives of a carboxylic acid, which we'll study later in the same unit. But right now, I'm just putting in saying that it's a derivative of a carboxylic acid. So, acid chloride is having an acyl group, which is referred as RCO group. R group is just alkyl group. CO group just is carbonyl group, but when you combine together RCO, we call it as acyl group. So acyl chloride, to that acyl group a halogen is attached, and that halogen is chlorine, that's for acyl chloride. So if I want to prepare one particular example, one particular aldehyde, which is very important for us, okay, that is benzaldehyde. What is that reaction is, if you want to prepare benzaldehyde from an acyl chloride, I should start with an acyl chloride of the type C6H5COCl. This is called as benzoyl chloride. See the name of the acid chloride or acyl chloride, benzoyl. I am making it very clear. B-E-N-Z-O-Y-L, benzoyl chloride. So this benzoyl chloride is subjected to reduction using hydrogen in the presence of palladium supported over barium sulfate. Benzoyl chloride, when it is treated with hydrogen in the presence of palladium supported over barium sulfate, what does it gives you? It gives you the product that is called benzaldehyde. See the product what I am getting here, which is benzaldehyde. This reaction we commonly call it as Rosenmund's reduction, one of the very, very important reaction, a named reaction which we study under this particular unit. That is Rosenmund's reduction, very, very important reaction, very, very important, okay? Rosenmund's reduction. Reduction means addition of hydrogen, that's what we do. That hydrogen is added in the presence of palladium, an active metal, in the presence of barium sulfate, so that benzaldehyde is obtained. So I'll repeat here, when benzoyl chloride is treated with hydrogen in the presence of palladium supported over barium sulfate, you get benzaldehyde. And this reaction we call it as Rosenmund's reduction. Very, very important reaction. Okay? Very, very important reaction. That is one of the methods of preparation of aldehydes. The second method of preparation is from nitriles. Students, you may be knowing this nitriles is actually the IUPAC name given for cyanides, okay? Alkyl cyanides, in the IUPAC system we call it as alkane nitrile. So these nitriles, how to convert it into aldehyde? For that, there is one special reaction here, one of the very important reaction coming under this category, which we call as Stefan reaction. Okay, we call it as Stefan reaction, very, very important reaction, just like Rosenmüller's reduction. In this reaction, what we do? In this reaction, we start with a cyanide. Cyanide, I can represent like this, RCN, or also called as alkane nitrile. This is made to react with stannous chloride in the presence of HCl. Alkane nitrile or alkyl cyanide, when it is made to react with stannous chloride and HCl, what does it give you? It gives you an intermediate product, what I call as an imine. The intermediate product is obtained here, what you call as an imine, I-M-I-N-E. And this imine is then subjected to hydrolysis, acid hydrolysis. And what does it give you? The product, what is obtained here, is an aldehyde. Okay, I'll repeat here. An alkyl cyanide or alkane nitrile is made to react with stannous chloride and HCl. It gives you the product an imine, an intermediate product, which on hydrolysis gives you the product an aldehyde. This is how you can convert a nitrile to an aldehyde by Stefan's reaction. Okay? You can select an aldehyde, for example, acetaldehyde, for which R group is CH3. So here also R group should be CH3. So CH3CN, which is nothing but methyl cyanide or ethane nitrile. CH3CN, methyl cyanide or ethane nitrile, it gives you acetaldehyde or ethanol. That's how we can go with the preparation of aldehyde. Similarly, if I go with the second method of converting a nitrile into an aldehyde, is by a process called again a reduction, but using one specific reducing agent by reduction with dibal H. What is dibal H? It is diisobutyl aluminium hydride. Diisobutyl aluminium hydride, that is a reducing agent, dibal H. Okay, and what we do here, again the method is same. You start with the cyanide, RCN, nitrile cyanide. When it is subjected to reduction with diisobutyl aluminium hydride, which I can represent like this, diisobutyl aluminium hydride, followed by hydrolysis, gives you the product an aldehyde. So aldehyde is obtained by reduction of alkyl cyanide, okay, that is nitrile, using diisobutyl aluminium hydride, followed by hydrolysis. So these are the two different ways of preparation of aldehydes. So I can just repeat here, Stefan reaction, a reaction in which alkyl cyanides or alkane nitrile is treated with stannous chloride and HCl, which gives you the product imine as an intermediate, which is subjected to hydrolysis, which gives you the product aldehyde. By reduction in dibal H, where alkyl cyanide is reduced using diisobutyl aluminium hydride followed by hydrolysis, gives you RCHO, which is an aldehyde. That is how we can go with preparation from nitriles. The next method what you are preparing here is from hydrocarbons. From hydrocarbons. Now, you know now hydrocarbons you can convert into aldehydes and ketones. But here we are specifically preparing what you call as aromatic aldehyde. That is, we are preparation of aromatic aldehyde. Preparation of aromatic aldehyde from hydrocarbons. Now, what are the different ways of preparation of aromatic aldehydes here? This first method here, again, which is one of the very important reaction for us, which is called as Etard reaction. Etard reaction, another important reaction coming under this category. We have seen now two important named reaction, Rosenmund's reduction as well as Stefan reaction. In the same category, we come across with Etard reaction, which is used for the preparation of aromatic aldehyde, that too benzaldehyde. So, how to prepare benzaldehyde? For this, we are going with a method. That method we call as Etard reaction, in which we start with toluene. You know that toluene is a aromatic hydrocarbon which is having an alkyl group, methyl group attached to the benzene ring. Methyl benzene is the IUPAC name, but I call simply here as toluene. Toluene. So this toluene is subjected to oxidation using chromyl chloride. You know that chromyl chloride, CrO2Cl2, in the presence of carbon disulfide. Chromyl chloride in the presence of carbon disulfide. What does it give? It gives you one intermediate product, which I can represent it in this way. The intermediate product is represented in this way. It is CHOCrOHCl2 twice. Toluene, when it is treated with chromyl chloride in carbon disulfide, it gives you an intermediate product, CHOCrOHCl2 twice, which is then subjected to hydrolysis, which gives you the product that is benzaldehyde, So just I will repeat the process. We are starting with toluene. Toluene is subjected to reaction with chromyl chloride in carbon disulfide. An intermediate product is obtained, and which on hydrolysis gives you the product benzaldehyde. That is the reaction what you call as Etard reaction. The second method is again from toluene, but here we are going with a different route. What is that route here? I can take the reaction like this. I am starting with toluene. This toluene is made to react with chromic anhydride in the presence of acetic anhydride. Toluene is made to react with chromic anhydride in the presence of acetic anhydride. What does it give you? It gives you an intermediate product, which I call it as benzylidene diacetate. See the intermediate product, benzylidene diacetate. Okay? And this benzylidene diacetate is then subjected to hydrolysis. Which gives you the product that is benzaldehyde. See the reaction. I started with toluene, reaction with chromic anhydride and acetic anhydride. It gives you an intermediate product by name benzylidene diacetate, which on hydrolysis gives you the product benzaldehyde. That is how we can go with another way of converting toluene to benzaldehyde. So among these two methods, the first method is an important method because it is a named reaction, Itard reaction. Toluene, chromyl chloride in carbon disulfide, an intermediate is obtained, hydrolysis gives you benzaldehyde. The next one, what we can start now is, again from toluene. So the third method of preparation of aromatic aldehyde is by side chain chlorination of toluene. Side chain chlorination of toluene. So what is it, side chain chlorination? Suppose if I go with toluene once again. Toluene, okay. Here you can see that this is an aromatic compound. An aromatic compound is undergoing one specific reaction, what you call as electrophilic substitution, where the hydrogen atom attached to the benzene ring is substituted by the electrophile. That is electrophilic substitution. But here it is not electrophilic substitution, instead of that, it is the side chain substitution, where the hydrogen atom attached to the alkyl group gets substituted. That is what you call a side chain substitution. How it happens, it depends upon the reaction condition. Suppose if I take toluene, same toluene, and react it with chlorine in the presence of halogen carrier like ferric chloride or iron, you get the ortho para derivatives. That I don't want. So what I'm doing here is I'm subjecting this toluene to chlorination in the presence of sunlight or UV light. Now hydrogen atom attached to the methyl group gets successively substituted. First it will substitute one hydrogen. You get one product called benzyl, B-E-N-Z-Y-L, benzyl. If you go for further substitution, it gives CHCl2. That is what I want. That is, I am getting here one intermediate product, which I call it as CHCl2. We call it as benzyl chloride. Okay. Toluene, when subjected to side chain chlorination with chlorine in the presence of diffuse sunlight, it gives you benzyl chloride. And this benzyl chloride, when subjected to hydrolysis, what will happen now? These two chlorine atoms get substituted with the OH group from water, and the two OH group comes on the same carbon, because of which it becomes unstable and immediately decomposed and gives you the product that is an aldehyde, that is benzaldehyde. An aldehyde, a benzaldehyde is obtained. So I'll repeat here, side chain chlorination, toluene, when made to react with chlorine in the presence of diffuse sunlight or UV light, gives you benzyl chloride, benzyl, see this, CHCl, two hydrogen atom from CH3 substituted, benzyl chloride. This benzyl chloride, when subjected to hydrolysis, then you get the product benzaldehyde. That is how we are going with the preparation of benzaldehyde from this method. Okay? Then comes the next reaction. The next reaction in the series, that is by Getterman-Koch reaction, okay? Another important reaction that is by Gatterman, Gatterman-Koch reaction. Gatterman-Koch reaction. Now, what is this reaction? This is a reaction in which you can convert benzene directly to benzaldehyde. Benzene is directly converted to benzaldehyde. That is, if I want to convert it like this, I start with benzene. Benzene. This benzene is made to react with carbon monoxide and HCl. Carbon monoxide and HCl in the presence of anhydrous aluminium chloride or cuprous chloride. See the process. Benzene is made to react with carbon monoxide and HCl in the presence of anhydrous aluminium chloride or cuprous chloride, which gives you the product, that is benzaldehyde, which gives you the product benzaldehyde. Okay, so benzene is now converted to benzaldehyde by a process called Gatterman-Koch reaction. Gatterman-Koch reaction. This is how we are going with the explanation for the preparation of aldehydes. So in this preparation, as you have seen, students, up till now, we are coming across with some very, very important reactions, especially the named reaction, which I can start with Rosenmund's reduction, Stefan reaction, Etard reaction, as well as Gatterman-Koch reaction. Each reaction has got its own weightage. Each reaction is also very, very important. I tried to simplify the steps. We are not giving much of the intermediate steps not required at this stage. So at least these basic steps you have to write. Without knowing the steps, there is no question of getting full marks in this particular part. So you have to follow the writing pattern of studying. Without writing this reaction, 100% is not possible to write the equation so easily. So just keep on trying this type of reaction. So that is where we can take the preparation of aldehydes. Now let me move on with the next part, that is methods of preparation of ketones. Here also there are three different methods of preparation of ketone. Out of that, the first method is from acyl chlorides. Just now we have prepared aldehydes from acyl chlorides. Now we are preparing ketones from acyl chlorides. How to convert an acyl chloride into a ketone? For that, the process is very, very simple, where we start with an acyl chloride, which I can represent in a general form like this, RCOCl, and this is made to react with dialkyl cadmium, dialkyl cadmium, dialkyl, let me represent here, dialkyl cadmium, R dash, R2 dash, dialkyl cadmium, okay? So this on reaction gives you the product RCOR dash plus CdCl2. If I want to go for balancing of this reaction, you can see here we have got 2R and 2RCOR dash. Okay, see the reaction here. I'm starting with an acid halide, acid chloride, and I'm heating it with dialkyl cadmium. R2 means 2 times alkyl group, dialkyl cadmium, which gives you the product, a ketone. A ketone is obtained like this. If I consider one simple example here, suppose if I start with acetyl chloride, CA3COCl, acetyl chloride. ಇದೊಂದು ಮಾಡಿ ಹೋಗ್ತೇನೆ ಓಕೆ ಆಯಿತು ಅವರಿಗೆ ಹೇಳಿದೆ ನಾನು 11:30 ಹೇಳಿ ಸರಿಗೆ ಹೌದು ಇದೊಂದು ನನಗೆ ಎರಡು ಉಂಟು ಅಲ್ಲಿಗೆ ಪ್ರಿಪ್ರೇಷನ್ ಆಗ್ತದೆ ಮತ್ತೆ ಇಲ್ಲಾರ ಅರ್ಧ ನಿಲ್ತದೆ ಸೊ ಎಸಿಟೈಲ್ ಕ್ಲೋರೈಡ್ ವೆನ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಮೇಡ್ ಟು ರಿಯಾಕ್ಟ್ ವಿತ್ dialkyl, that is dimethyl cadmium. This gives you the product 2CH3 C double bond O CH3 plus CD Cl2. So if I start with acetyl chloride or ethanoyl chloride, I end up here with a product that is called acetone. That's how we can go with the first method of preparation of ketone. The second method of preparation of ketone is from nitriles, and as you know, nitriles is considered to be again alkyl cyanides, which you have studied in the preparation of aldehydes just now. That is, Stefan's reaction gives you an aldehyde from nitrile. But here, how to convert a nitrile into a ketone? For that, the method is very simple. We start with an alkyl cyanide, or what we call as an alkane nitrile, and you heat it with a Grignard reagent, which is represented as R-MgX. This gives you an addition product, which I can represent as RC R dash double bond N MgX. And this, when subjected to hydrolysis, gives you the product a ketone. This is how we can go with the preparation of ketone from alkyl cyanide or alkane nitrile by reacting it with Grignard reagent, which gives you an intermediate product which on hydrolysis gives you the product ketone. That is how we can go with the second method of preparation from nitrile. And the third method of preparation is from benzene. By Friedel-Crafts acylation. Just now we have seen from benzene how to convert it into benzaldehyde by a process called Gatterman-Koch reaction. Now I am going with Friedel-Crafts acylation. What is that Friedel-Crafts acylation? The reaction is very simple. We start with benzene, and you heat it with an acylating agent, that is an acid halide RCOCl, in the presence of anhydrous aluminium chloride, which gives you the product a ketone, which I can represent in this way, C double bond OR plus HCl. We end up here with an aromatic ketone. Depending upon the nature of R group, you can have different types of aromatic ketones. So that is how we can go with Friedel-Crafts acylation reaction, where benzene is made to react with an acid chloride in the presence of anhydrous aluminium chloride catalyst to give you a ketone, that is an aromatic ketone. So that is how we can go with the preparations of ketones. So with this method of preparation of ketone, we have just finished the first part of that unit, where we discussed mainly about the nomenclature part as well as methods of preparation of aldehydes, ketones, then aldehydes, and then ketones.